Hi everybody, today is April 1st, 2013. They're going to have an urgent meeting over the latest earthquakes that they've been having there near El Heirro. Actually, it's on the side of the volcano. The Committee of Civil Protection Plan for Volcanic Risk, PVOCA, will meet today to discuss the latest seismic events near El Heirro. I reported late last night, early this morning, they were having a rise in earthquakes. It's hard to get an accurate recording because they keep messing with the machine. Originally this here and this area here, they were 3-point earthquakes. They had turned down their earthquake machine. Possibly so people wouldn't kind of panic when they seen the large earthquake. And then I suppose they turned the machine back up. And then it looks like sometime around 4 o'clock universal time, they turned the machine back up. And there was a series of 3-point earthquakes, evidently, what they're saying, the largest being a 3.8. It was felt and reported on the island, this 3.8 earthquake. And it came from the same location that they've been having these quakes. The quakes seem to be coming from the second chamber, somewhere between 22 and 17 kilometers in depth. I reported late last night that these quakes were starting to occur. The first one being a 3.4, then there was a 3.1, another 3.3. You see there's a whole series of 3-point earthquakes. What this means is more magma is rising to this second chamber, which would create more of a bulge and a buildup of pressure. And these 3-point earthquakes continue even now. Last one was at 10:32. It was a 3.0 at 17 kilometers in depth. Here's an image of the spectrogram P waves of the earthquakes when they started about 4 a.m. Here it is at 5 o'clock. After that, there was several hours of calm, and then the earthquakes started up again. This is between 10 and 11 universal time. See little spikes and then it started calming down again. Here's the latest image. It's 13:14 universal time. So the island is still on a state of yellow, which means a state of preparation just in case something major does happen. Because of the lack of funding, they have to use volunteers to go about the island to take readings of the gases. The equipment they're using evidently is limited because they're only recording CO2 and not sulfur. If they have CO2 coming up over the entire island, they have to have sulfur as well. Here's the latest image that they're showing at IGN of the recent earthquakes. Now you notice here they got three squares in red at the center, very top of the island. Red means it's been within the last 12 hours. Yellow would be 12 to 24 hours. Green is 24 hours. Square is magnitude between 1.5 to 2.7. Triangles would be 2.7 or greater. In circles, 1.5 or less. And then the blue would be 36 hours ago. But this area here is what's been evacuated, and the uplift is over 11 centimeters, last reported. I'm sure it's risen more since then. Now, on El Heirro, they used to record the gases, just like they still do on La Palma and the other islands. Here is El Heirro. They used to have a monitor down here, but currently they only have this one. And as you can see, they're not recording sulfur and only recording what they call pollutants. And there's no data for pollutants. And they say it's because of a lack of funding. Here they are recording the sulfur. You can see it's 13 parts per million, if I'm reading that right. And this is La Palma. This is one of the stations they had to record the different gases. Here's another one. 8 parts per million. And this is for sulfur, 7. But they don't do that for El Heirro. The recent earthquakes were felt on both La Palma and La Gomera. So, back to the 4.9 earthquake that was registered yesterday. Because of that, they're going to have an emergency meeting today to discuss what to do and how to censor the information, I imagine. These islands depend greatly on tourism. And when the quake started back in 2011, it just devastated the economy for these people. A lot of the marine life around the island was killed by the release of the gases. The quakes are larger than the last eruption. They're lasting longer than the last eruption. There's been more damage reported to private property this time than the last eruption. The rock slides have been larger than the last eruptions. Now, they talked before that when the earthquakes got to a depth of 5 kilometers, that's when they would decide to evacuate the islands, and not until then. So I'm sure it's the same now as it was then. When the eruptions happened, the gases were so strong, people said they had constant dizziness they felt throughout the island. They had a mobile truck there in La Restinga that was monitoring the air. When the air quality there at La Restinga was within acceptable levels, they would allow the people to return home and then evacuate them when the levels got too high or it was unsafe. So the people were constantly going home and coming back every day. But to think that they were taking chances with these people with the gases and allowing them to go home for, 4 or 5 hours and then saying, oh, you gotta leave again, is unbelievable. So they have roads with tunnels that are currently closed. And it's currently going through a period of calm. You can see right here they messed with the machine again. And I'm sure that's under the authority of whoever runs the island there. You can see it right there and right there that they've been messing with the machine. So it's hard to get an accurate recording. It's hard to tell just exactly how strong these earthquakes are. But it is currently going through a period of calm, which will again break out into large quakes. It's just a matter of time. All right, well, bookmark my site. I'll keep you up to date. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.